Hi everyone, this is Haider Pasha from Palo Alto Networks. As you know, I'm the Chief Security Officer. I've been with Palo Alto Networks now roughly 6 weeks, and it's been an amazing 6 weeks. To tell you the truth, the majority of the conversations that I've had with customers has been around cloud computing, but there's also been a lot of discussion around machine learning and artificial intelligence. One of the challenges that a lot of my peers in the industry have been talking to me about is the relevance of machine learning as they look at cybersecurity. So there was an article that I referenced probably about 2 weeks ago that the MIT Tech Review did, which I thought was a fantastic way of explaining how machine learning actually works. However, the challenge around machine learning still remains. You know, how do you prevent data poisoning, you know, the ability of actually having bad data be injected in part of good data? Now, I wanted to address that very briefly with you. I can tell you the challenge of securing machine learning and the algorithms that exist will continue to be an area of focus for Palo Alto Networks as well as the general cybersecurity community. You still need this, the same type of security frameworks and security technologies in order to protect a machine learning system, whether it's your CPUs, whether it's your processing power, whether you're doing it on-prem or possibly on the cloud. The key focus area for companies like Palo Alto Networks is to make sure that our customers understand that, you know, machine learning isn't the end all and be all in terms of protection around cybersecurity. My personal belief is that in the next probably half a decade or so, we're going to start to see a more and more reliance on machine learning, where almost perhaps even 80% of our cybersecurity jobs will be reliant on having machines do the job for us, yet 20% will still remain on having human beings actually interact and take decisions. In order for us to be successful in that area, of course, we need the right level of contextual data and be able to have those artificial intelligence and machine learning systems be able to parse that vast amounts of good data against when they do detect that bad data. So again, I'm traveling the region. I'm really looking forward to speaking to a lot of customers across Middle East and Africa and the wider global reach that myself and my peers in the industry have. Ping me if you have more detailed questions, and I look forward to speaking with you. Thank you.